my junior, my most memorable event was getting lost three times on the way here.
Hey, it's coming. Pretty expensive, so those of you who haven't done it yet, save your money.
Hey, I'm Rachel Leary. This is Derek Gary, Jeff Watt, and we are the sophomore attendants for the 96 prom. Any questions?
Yeah, how'd you get in being the sophomore?
This is my Saturday. Well, she signed me up, and I didn't even know about it. I was chosen as a student council member to go. I was supposed to start Saturday school, but can't just go. This is my We're here, and we're having a lot of fun, all right? Yeah.
There you go. I guess I'm doing it.
Amy Condry.
Sean Murphy.
And I would like to know, what's your most memorable occasion of this year?
Oh, gosh. I don't know. Prom's pretty memorable, though.
First day of college.
And what college are you going to?
College of Wooster.
Aha. Have you ever been in jail?
No, not me.
No.
Still working on it, huh?
We're trying. Maybe tonight.
Okay, well, have fun.
Graduation now, and I'm graduating, so this will probably be my final broadcast. Standing here with Mike Olson, Emily Lowe, and a host of others, and we're all just getting ready. We're a little nervous right now because for some of us, it'll be the last time each other again, ever. So we're a little nervous, but I think we'll get through it. We're also a little warm. It's going to be real hot in that gymnasium. Mike, you okay? He's a little broken up about this whole thing.
Mike's been that way.
He's an emotional guy, isn't he, Emily?
The last month of school in May.
Yeah, but it's been a fun 4 years. I think everybody will agree about this.
The last chance to say something for the video yearbook.
Goodbye, I'm out of here.
No, this one comes from Philippians 3:10.
How about Devin?
No, I don't. Do you have anything to say? Well, take your education seriously.
The ups are slow, but the earth is patient.
So you guys want to say goodbye to Wooster High School?
See ya.
Hi, Wooster High School.
Oh, God.
Crazy boy.
Give me some beer.
what you're saying to the people in the future who will be left behind after you guys leave?
Go to Club Bedrock. Yes, Bedrock.
Live long, don't let the teachers get on your nerves too much. Have fun.
Don't sprain your ankle before graduation because it's a pain
here.
Oh,
good luck to the other. Yeah, good luck to all the classes. And try to make it. Look, everybody.
Do as much in high school as you possibly can because this is it. This is all.
Oh, no,
do whatever you feel like doing and do it.
And party.
Well, in retrospect, Wooster High School is a good place, certainly. A lot of changes, maturity, adolescence, and all those hardships. Yeah, but paid off. Good luck to all you.
Little words of wisdom. It comes from Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. It says, trust in the Lord with all of your heart, lean not on your own understanding, and all of your ways acknowledge him, and he will make your path straight. That's all I've got to say.
I can't get all four of them.
Words of wisdom for the video yearbook, you guys.
Yeah, we're out of here.
Bye.
The world cried, and wait, you cried and the world rejoiced. Live your life so that when you die, the world cries and you rejoice.
Well, I said this is the old high school when you asked me. What are your last words? You gotta know when to hold them. You gotta know when to fold them. You gotta know when to walk away, and you gotta know when to run. Peace.
Bye, I'm out of school. I'm out of school. No more school. How do you take my picture?
Hi.
We have a picture request. Tim Nolan, you certainly have something to say to the video yearbook.
I certainly have something to say to the video yearbook. It's been a great couple of years, and I wish everybody else the best of luck in making it to this level.
Make it short.
Thank you.
Be what you want the world to be.
The past 4 years I've spent between the cozy, dilapidated old high school and the technologically superior and a sterile new one, I've learned many things. Many things on a variety of subjects, a hodgepodge of important topics such as the myth of Procrustes, Horner's algorithm, the proper rules of table tennis, the intricacies of the paragraph planner, the appropriate tonguing of a sforzando, the mating rituals of the Yanomamo tribe, the location of manganese nodules, and the warning signs of scabies. I've been taught by an equal variety of teachers, from superior to lackluster, interesting to nap-worthy, friendly to acerbic, and from intelligent to, hey, I've got tenure.
I think that if you can't stand up for what you believe in and do what you think is right, then you really can't be yourself. If you're just following what other people think all the time, then you're not an individual, and you just, I think you need to stand up for what you believe in. My second point is to live life to the fullest and remain optimistic at all times, because I think you should always try new things, be different. I mean, you be whatever you want to be, and never let anyone say don't do it, because go out there and just do whatever.
4 years ago, we came to Wooster High School anonymous freshmen, and today we are leaving as a great senior class, for the most part mature, studious, and caring of the world around us. We are now heading off onto a new adventure, but this time we will not be anonymous, because the world is watching and waiting, for as of yet, our generation is unnamed. Our generation has to make its mark on this world before it can be labeled by Newsweek, Time, and other such magazines. While looking at you and hoping that the rest of the senior classes in America have so much potential, I realize that we can change the way the generations in America have been going. Bernard of Chartres, an 11th century philosopher, once said, "Generations are like dwarves. Seated on the shoulders of giants, they see more than the ancients and more distant."
Every day I see unhappy people, people dissatisfied with their jobs, their relationships, their health, and their lifestyles. At one time, all of these people were young kids with wild and imaginative ideas about what the future would bring. Yet few of these original dreams came true. Perhaps it was their elders who dissuaded them from striving for what seemed unrealistic goals. Perhaps these children felt obligated to resort to a more traditional lifestyle, or perhaps as these kids grew older, they simply lost their courage to be different. I believe that happiness is the most important element in life. This is why I would like to tell my classmates not to let anything stand in the way of your goals and your happiness.
So, after countless hours of cramming for history exams, of standing shop projects to smooth perfection, of studying the intricacies of the ceiling in our favorite first period classes, we finally arrived at graduation. Our brains teeming and our hands tingling with the information and skills amassed over the past 18 years. But in addition to acquiring pure knowledge, we've also developed and refined our ability to analyze that knowledge. We've all taken a step back from the books and keyboards and special projects to think critically about the information being taught. We've all had to reason through those tricky relationships and decide how to deal with our friends. Although it is often overlooked, this ability to question our lives and the world around us is just as important as the factual information that we learn.
Ursula K. Le Guin, an American writer, once said, "The only thing that makes life possible is permanent, intolerable uncertainty, not knowing what comes next." We thought elementary school, the first time away from mom and dad, was scary and uncertain. Then we hit Edgewood and knew true fear. The original high school brought additional doubts. How early did we have to get up in order to find a place to park? Did we have enough time to make it to Bueller's and back before the bell? Were they really going to make us get into that disgusting pool? Unsettled again, we moved into the land of Oz, where parking was plenty, lunch was confined to campus, and the pool was an Olympic event. Now it's time to travel again, and the best advice I can think to give you is, plan your life as if it were your vacation. Pick a great destination, fill up the tank, pack for emergencies, and get some real good direction. Your first solid direction is to turn your tassel.
Thank you, Melissa. If you would please all stand and join in the singing of the alma mater. The words are on the wall and in your program. Graduates find their cap if they can. We will invite the symphonic band to lead us as we recess out, ending our commencement ceremony. I present to you, graduates, the class of 1996.